going to film my video outside today. It's very, very noisy in this garden, especially today for some reason. So hopefully I'm just going to stop talking and get on with it. After the marathon that was the beaded bug video, which was an hour and a half of me talking and my husband going mental trying to squash it down to half an hour. Today I'm going to transform this mirror into something a lot nicer than this. And for the first time I'm making something for a little boy. My little nephew Flynn is going to have a new bedroom soon and I thought it would be nice to make him something for his new room. So I'm going to be making a dinosaur mirror. So the first thing I'm going to do is just to give it a good clean and quick rub down. Now quick rub down. I found this on the side of the road. I find lots of interesting things on the side of the street actually. I was going to put newspaper and masking tape around the mirror, but actually it's quite loose, so I think I'm just going to remove the mirror. It'll be so much easier to paint. Okay, I should leave this to dry in the sun while I cover the table and get ready for spraying. Okay, I've got my spray paint. Wilco's own spray paint in green, two different greens, and I've got some dinosaurs here. They're very small, lightweight dinosaurs. I'm going to spray paint the orange and red ones because that's not what I'm after, but I will keep these more greeny grey colours. I'll leave those. I don't mind those. But I'm just going to spray. I thought that one's okay. I'm just going to spray the bright ones when I spray the mirror. I don't really know what the colours are going to look like, so I might just spray a bit on. I'm just going to spray this one, see which I like the best. Okay, this is the dark green. It's very dark. Let's try this one. That is very fluorescent. I don't really like either, if I'm honest. I'm going to use them both so that it's like camouflaging. Yeah, I'm going to use them both. So I'm going to start off with this fluorescent one. At least it's green, so when it goes all over the plants, it won't matter. The wind seems to be blowing this paint directly at the camera, so I hope it's okay. I hope it's not just going to be, you're looking at me through a fog of green. This is probably the vilest colour I've ever seen. But then again, I'm not a 4-year-old boy. Isn't this typical? It wasn't windy at all before I started spray painting and now the wind's just blowing everything everywhere. Okay, so I painted it this vile colour. which obviously I didn't realise when I bought this collar. Well, I should have done, really. It is exactly the same as the lid. I think I was hoping for something else. But I'm not going to despair because I've got this dark green now. So I'm going to try and do like a camouflagey effect. I can't remember when I just did this. I've just been chatting. Feels a bit tangy, so I think I'll just leave it. I'll leave it a little bit longer. Okay, I'm going to use this dark green now to try and do camouflagey effect. Actually, I'm trying to disguise how vile this shade of green is, and I'm also going to do the opposite side to these little dinosaurs. I'll do that first. Ready? Here we go. Okay, I'm quite liking this effect now, actually. It's very Jurassic Park. And I think it looks quite nice. I'll bring the camera closer so you get a better idea. I'll just finish spraying with this dark green. Yes, I really like that. I'm not just trying to convince myself. I actually really like that. Okay, so here's the frame dried. I'm really happy with the colour. So now I'm going to, I've sprayed my dinosaurs, a mixture of the two colours. I've left some of them the grey or the brown. And I'm just going to stick them on now with the hot glue gun. I also found these little stones that I've had, not stones, like squashed marble things. I've had these for 30 years. I keep them in a tin and I can't tell you the hours and hours of pleasure that little kids have had. They've wanted to play with nothing else. When they come round, I get this tin out and they're just the best things. Few have been eaten. So I'm going to use those as well just to zhuzh it up a little bit. Off I go. I don't know why I'm listening to see if it's switched off. Wait till it gets hot. Yes, it's getting warmer. Fiddling around, adding a few more marbles. I think it's cool, I really like it. I think I would like to make the dinosaur colour a little bit more blended to the frame. But now I've gone and stuck the pebbles on. And I want these to stay shiny. So I'm going to put masking tape over the pebbles and then just give it a really fine little spray just so the dinosaurs blend more with the colour. Okay, I've masked my marbles and I'm just going to give the dinosaurs a little light spray. Okay, I've just got to wait for it to dry, clean the mirror, and put it all together. Okay, so I'm just going to, this was stapled in the back. But I'm just going to have to take the old staples out, otherwise it won't sit flat enough. So I'm just going to try and prise. Oh, they're coming out easily. Prise the old ones out. so that the mirror sits nice and flat. I don't want to hold it too hard because it's not quite dry.
Okay, I'm going to put the glass in now. And unfortunately this won't tip flat. Okay, now put the backing. And now I'm going to attempt to staple it in, being careful not to catch the glass, because if I do, it'll smash, and I do not need 7 years bad luck. Right, here we go. Right, you've obviously got to press it hard, so I can't, because I can't do this with one hand. I'm going to have one more go, but I need to hold this firm. I obviously haven't been to enough body pump classes because I cannot do this. So this is going to have to be a job for Phil. Phil! Okay, can you see me in the mirror? Shall I look at the camera or in the mirror? I'll look in the mirror. So I thought I would just show you. Gosh, I look really tanned. I've only been out for about an hour. Anyway, I thought I would show you what I did with the snake. Here we go. Where is it? There. So now the snake is fighting the beetle. So this is the finished mirror. I'm really pleased with it. This was actually a really quick and fun thing to do. You could do fairies, you could do unicorns, you could do those little Lego people. In fact, I might start my own business because I really enjoyed doing that. This. So there's just one thing left to do, and that is to ask my little friends what they think. They're fighting to look in this mirror. Okay, I shall see you next time. Bye.